Voting continues in Bengal, the campaigns heating up in Kerala, and we're at Alimuddin Street, the CPIM headquarters in Kolkata. We're going to try and catch up with Sitaram Yechury, General Secretary of the CPIM and member of the Rajya Sabha. He's going to talk to us about the elections, political violence, as well as what's going to be happening in Parliament. So, four of your comrades have been killed in this campaign cycle, in this election cycle. How badly is the violence going to affect the voter turnout, and how much are you worried about that?
Well, I'm considerably worried about it. I mean, worried both about the violence and about the efforts being made to not allow a free and fair election. Because, I think we all of us have to understand, free and fair election is the backbone of Indian democracy. If you don't allow that, people lose faith in democracy, then it means disaster. So we are worried about it, and we have been asking the Election Commission, because they alone have the mandate, constitutional mandate. Yes, they are targeting us, they are killing our comrades, but more such attacks happen, greater will be the people's resistance. What is happening in Bengal is something extraordinary. I mean, this pressure is from below, from the people. They are the ones who today forced this sort of a coming together. The objective is to liberate Bengal from the Trinamool rule. That's why the slogan we gave, oust the Trinamool government, save Bengal, has found a reverberation. So beyond that, the issues will be considered at that time. Our irreconcilability with the Congress is well known, and that will continue. I mean, our opposition to all the policies and what they represent, that is there. But here, as I said, it's not anything that's happened from the top with the Congress. It is the pressure from below. And that pressure from below, I'm sure Kerala people are mature enough to understand. They already are understanding. Kerala leaders have also said so very clearly. Of course, I mean, the entire positive agenda is what our entire manifesto is all about. I mean, we have said what needs to be done and what was undone that was done earlier during the last 5 years. You see, there is no future for Bengal unless there is some industrialization and growth in employment. That cannot happen with the land saturation that you already have. It has to be industry. People used to come from all over the country to Kolkata for a better livelihood. People are now leaving Bengal and going to other states for a livelihood. In my generation, the students would always want to do their higher education here. Today is the other way around. Youngsters going out, farmers committing suicide, people going out to work. That is the pathetic situation which Bengal wants to reverse. It has percolated on rural Bengal, and much to my pleasant surprise. Pleasant in the sense that issues percolated. Unpleasant in the sense people are suffering. Every peasant or rural Bengal person also invested in these chit fund companies. That is the unfortunate reality. So this corruption is not an urban phenomenon. It's not something confined only to the urban educated class. It has gone down to the rural poor. And they are very determined to ensure that they get back their money. Didi Bhai, Modi Bhai. That has been the slogan. And this alliance or this understanding of match fixing began with the Singur agitation. Modi taking Singur factory to Gujarat. Mamata making that deal with him. I mean, this is an axis that has been there for a long, long time, and now again it's come out what the Chief Minister once said, that BJP is the Trinamool Congress's natural ally. Yeah. So that's always been the case. There's nothing that this election is going to contribute much anymore.
Finally, Derek O'Brien's little Photoshop gaffe recently, the Trinamool Congress's. Will you have some fun in Parliament with that?
Well, first of all, it is an act of complete desperation. There's a complete sense of frustration and a desperation to stoop to such levels. It's ridiculous, absolutely. It'll come up in the Parliament definitely, because Mr. O'Brien happens to be a member of the Rajya Sabha. And it'll come up definitely both in the ambit of the Ethics Committee and in the ambit of general dignity of the House, and therefore whether it means any privilege consideration.